Yo, what's going on YouTube? This is Tuesday morning. Actually, Monday morning. 8:44 a.m. right now. 10 a.m. I have class, man. I'm 70 calories burned. I don't believe this. I went from here to here. It's like long time, long walk. I don't think I just burned 70 calories. Something wrong here. Yeah, today I'm gonna buy a 64GB phone. For 150 bucks, I can flip it like 250 bucks even, because 6S is like 64GB. 6S 64GB is a good price, like a good price. 150 is really cheap, so there's a good profit in it. And today I have classes, like I have the microprocessor in this morning, like 10 a.m. and after that I have the control system one. After that I have the lab, I guess, but it's due next week. I'm trying to help my friend to find a house to get it done. And also I forgot to mention, I got all the marks, as you know, analog communications, microprocessor marks, better than I expected. My plan was to drop all the courses, you know, because I got fucked up. I said that I'm gonna meet the doctor about that tomorrow, about the issue I'm facing. Doctor, like I have appointment at 1 p.m. so I'm gonna meet the doctor. But the marks are better than I expected. Like before I have this idea of dropping, I have the plan, okay, if I get 7 or below in the microprocessor, I will drop that. And if I get 10 or below in the analog communication, I will drop that. But I end up getting 7.1 in microprocessor, analog communication 33, something like that. So better than I expected, because I thought I will get zero on those things, because I didn't know anything. I didn't put single hours in study. So better than I thought. That's good. I just want to go all the way and, you know, not really gonna care about the consequences. Let's see if I can pass all the tests. And today probably I'm gonna buy the phone, and my target is to, you know, get the G2 license. And also the project marks are posted. It's like 9 out of 10, and labs marks good, everything is good. And then yesterday after gym, I was talking about something. I was talking about it all makes sense, you know, it all makes sense. What do I mean by it all makes sense is, if you look at this thing, if you put a microscope over this, it's gonna seem like a dot or thing. It's not really connected. Even the letters you see, if you zoom it really well, it's all separate dots right there. You know, everything is floating around space, something like that. So in the deep level, everything is not connected really. Like there's a dot, and if you see that, it doesn't make any sense. You know, but when you in the big level, you can say this is a leaf, right? Because when you see it as a whole, you can see it's a leaf. But if you zoom it and look at it in a microscopic level, it doesn't make any sense, because it seems like a single cell, not even connected, even in our body, you know. So when you see outside, it makes sense, but when you see in a micro level, it doesn't make sense. That's how the whole thing is, you know. Our body, if you look at bloodstream, if you zoom the bloodstream, there are a bunch of bacteria, like living organisms, fighting with each other, killing each other, and you know, those there's a big war going on in our body. That's what he's keeping us harmony. Like, it has to happen. That's what our maintaining our, what do you call it? It has to happen. That's how the stable thing happened, you know. We are in harmony. That's what keep us healthy. If it doesn't happen, we are not healthy. You know, when the bad thing happen, like when something bad entered to our body, something has to attack that to destroy it, or it has to, you know, something has to happen in order to prevent us from that. That's what brings us harmony. And that's what happening in the world as well, you know. The war and all the stuff, the political things, wars, everything has to happen. In the big level, if you see, it's all keeps the world in harmony, man. You know, the war, the terrorism, everything. Like, there should be good people and bad people. Like, people has to die to make people, other people, you know, give a place, something like that. So when we see in a small level, it looks like everything bad, good, evil thing. But it has to happen, you know. The World War I has to happen. World War II has to happen. Hitler has to kill all those people. Because if the population is high, you know, everyone is going to die. So everything has to happen. In the big level, it all makes sense. That's what I was talking about yesterday. When we see the small thing, it doesn't make sense. But in the big level, everything makes sense. Even, I don't know, man, like, for us, it seems like, I don't know, like, maybe we are fighting in a big organism or something. I don't know. This universe might be a big living organism. I don't know, man. Because, you know, we might be a bacteria for a certain organism and we are living like this. I don't know. So everything is crazy, you know. We don't know what's going on in the universe. It's just a big bang. It's big bang in a body of some organism. I don't know. So it doesn't make sense. But in the big level, it all makes sense. We have to fight, we have to, everything has to happen. That's what keep us in harmony. That's what I was talking about yesterday. Today I'm going to talk about, you know, money doesn't buy pleasure. What do I mean by money doesn't buy pleasure is basically anything you want to enjoy, you know, anything you want to enjoy, you have to have the discipline. Like in our, you know, modern sense, discipline is like doing whatever you decide to, whether you feel like it or not. It's like, it feels like you have to, you put something like that, like when you hear that, it feels like you're put up with a task that you don't even want to do, like you know, some unfun actually, like not fun activity. That's how it sounds like in the modern sense. But if you want to really enjoy anything, you have to have the discipline. But if I use the other word, you have to have the skill. You know, you have to have the skill, because expressing, it's all about, you know, expressing your feelings. Like, let's say you want to express the feeling in the stone. You have to have the skill of how to cut the stone and everything, you know. That's how you can express yourself. Anything, in the music, you have to learn the music. Like, you have to develop the skill, you know. That's how you can express. Even making love, anything, you know, sailing boat. Anything you want, you have to learn the skill. Then only you can enjoy it really. But the first thing is, the teacher who is teaching those skills has to fascinate you with a subject. Like anything you can think about, even calculations. Any skill, if you really learn it really well, that will be an enjoyable thing. When you really learn something deeply, that will become enjoyable. That's why, you know, money doesn't buy pleasure. Because people buy those boats and they just party on the boat, but they don't know how to ride that boat because they are too busy doing that. They just buy this for a status symbol. You know, because it will take a lot of time to sail the boat and something like this. So they cannot really sail this boat, but they just use it as a status symbol and just party over there, you know. That's what I mean. You need to have the skill to really enjoy anything. That's our topic today. See you guys later.